Good morning, friends. Welcome back. I hope all of you are healthy and fit at home. This video is for the students of class 7, subject social science. Today we are going to start geography chapter 6, natural vegetation and wildlife. It is the first lecture of this chapter, and in today's lecture we are going to cover the topics. First one, introduction. Second, meaning of vegetation. Third, types of vegetation. And in last, homework will be assigned to you. So friends, let's we start today's discussion. Actually, our chapter is started by an experience of a girl named Salima. Salima was telling her experience of a hill stations, okay, where she visited in her school's summer camp. So let's we start from the reading of the paragraph given in our NCERT textbook. Salima was excited about the summer camp she was attending. She had gone to visit Manali in Himachal Pradesh, okay, and along with her classmates. She recalled how surprised she was to see the changes in the landform and natural vegetation as the bus climbed higher and higher. The deep jungles of the foothills comprising sal and teak slowly disappeared. She could see tall trees with thin pointed leaves and cone-shaped canopies on the mountain slopes. She learnt that those were coniferous trees. She noticed blooms of the bright flowers on tall trees. From Manali, as she was travelling up to Rohtang Pass, so she saw that the land was covered with short grass and snow in the some places. So friends, after reading this paragraph, we can come to know that in different areas, different regions, different vegetations are found. Like we see that the normal height trees like kikar, neem, shishams are found in the plain areas. And as we visit on any hilly area, where we found the trees which have a pointed leaves, means cone-shaped trees are found on the hilly areas. And beta, if we talk about the vegetation of the desert area, so in the desert area, we found most of the trees are, that means thorny trees. Thorny trees are found in the desert area. So in today's lecture, we are going to study about different types of vegetations and the areas, about the areas where they are found. Okay, so our first topic is, that is natural vegetation. So friends, first you know about the meaning of vegetation. Vegetation means ki the large, you can say, variety of trees, grass, bushes, this is there. And natural means which are given by nature. So what do you mean by the natural vegetation? Okay, means natural vegetation and wildlife are the plants and animals that survive naturally in a specific region and are part of the biosphere. Yes, friends, as we know that biosphere is the life supporting system, means that is the part of the earth where life is possible. Okay, so in this biosphere, means all natural vegetations and wildlife, okay, they survive without any interference of human beings. So natural vegetation means the vegetations which are grown themselves without any interference of human beings. And these vegetations are grown in the forest. Yes, as we know that in the forest that we do not grow the tree. In the forest, trees, vegetations, they grow themselves. So understood about the meaning of natural vegetations? Means the vegetations which are grown themselves without any interference of human beings. Okay? Yes. And natural vegetation means it refers to a plant community which has grown naturally without human aid and has been left undisturbed by humans for a long time. So understood? Already I have explained you the meaning of natural vegetations. Means they grow themselves, okay, in the natural environment and without any aid, help, or without any contribution of human beings. Okay, without any interference of human beings. So these are natural vegetations. Understood? Yes. Next, our topic is, that is classification of vegetation. Okay, so actually the vegetations are classified into different categories, and in which first is there, these are forest. Yes friends, what do you mean by forest? Actually, forest is the large area which is covered by a different type of plants. Okay, in this area, the plants are grown, okay, very close to each other and in large number. So what do you mean by the forest? Means in the forest, vegetations grow where temperature and rainfall are plentiful to support a tree cover. As we know that for the growth of the plants, that climate, temperature and rainfall are two main factors. Okay, and means these are the two main factors which affect the growth of plant. So forests are found in those area where there is a suitable temperature and enough amount of rainfall occur. Okay, next vegetation is there, that is grassland. Okay, and where grasslands are grown? Actually, this type of vegetation are grown in the area or the region of moderate rainfall. Okay, means the area where there is moderate rainfall, means not very high rainfall. Okay, and the area where there is no shortage of water, or there is no shortage, or less, you can say, less amount of rainfall. So means where there is a moderate rainfall, not very large amount and not in very less amount. So in these areas, grasslands are found. Means in this area, land is covered with grass, and these lands provide that pasture lands to the animals. Okay, our next type of vegetation is their shrubs. Okay, in shrubs means thorny shrubs and scrubs grown in the dry area. Means the areas which receive less amount of rainfall, in those area thorny plants are found, especially in the desert area. So friends, actually in our this chapter we will study about the only main types of vegetation forest in detail. Means we are going to study about the different types of forest. Okay, yes. So now factors affecting growth of vegetation, already we have discussed in our previous that lecture. Factor affecting growth of vegetation, just I told you there are the two main factors which affect the growth of the vegetation: temperature, okay, and you can say humidity or rainfall. Temperature and rainfall. The first factor which affect the growth of plant, that is temperature. And next factor which affect, that is moisture. Moisture means amount of rainfall. Okay, friends. Now, our next topic is there, types of forests. Okay. So, under this topic, we will study about the different type of forest, and in which first is there, that is tropical evergreen forest. Next one, tropical deciduous forest, temperate evergreen forest, temperate deciduous forest, Mediterranean vegetation, and coniferous forest. Okay, so let's we start. First we will study about tropical evergreen forest. Yes friends, like other natural resources, vegetations are also not distributed equally on the earth surface. Means some areas are there where there is forest, where there forest are found, and in some areas are also there on the earth where there is no vegetation. Okay, just I told you the main factors are, that is you can say climate and rainfall. These are the two main factors which affect the growth of plant. Tropical evergreen forest. Tropical. Okay, beta. In your previous classes, you have studied about the sphere of the earth. The earth is divided into three main parts, spheres. First, near the equator, that region is known as the areas which lie between the Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. So these areas known as tropical area, and above it means Tropic of Cancer to Arctic Circle and Tropic of Capricorn and Antarctic Circle. So the area lies between in these two, that you can see latitude, is known as temperate. Okay, tropical areas lies near the equator where sun rays fall directly. So in this area there is large amount of humidity. Okay, climate is hot and humid. So in tropical area, which type of climate is found? Hot and humid. Okay, this type of, and there is too much amount of rainfall in this area. So this area is good for the growth of plants, vegetations, and in these areas a large number of forests are found. Okay, now we will study about this forest, tropical evergreen forest. Yes, tropical evergreen forest are also known as tropical rainforest. You must know about it. Sometimes this question is asked in one mark, what is the other name of tropical evergreen forest? So tropical evergreen forest are also known as tropical rainforest. Okay, these thick forests occur in the regions near the equator and close to the tropics. This I told you now, that means the most of these forests are found in the tropical areas, means near the equator, close the two tropics, Tropic of Cancer, okay, and Tropic of Capricorn. Understood? So where that evergreen forests are found? Evergreen forests are found near the equator or between the area which lie Tropic of Cancer and Tropic of Capricorn. These forests are found in the regions which are hot and receive heavy rainfall throughout the year. Yes, friends, already I have told you that the areas which lie near the equator, they experience hot and humid climate. Okay, so evergreen forests are found in the area where there is hot and humid climate. Okay, but why there is hot and humid climate near the equator? As we know, near the equator, that sun rays fall directly. That's why this areas experience hot and humid, means due to this large amount of heat. So in this area there is large evaporation is there. Large amount of evaporation results high rainfall, and high rainfalls which results humidity. So in this area the climate is hot and humid. Next one is there, as there is no dry season, so the trees do not shed their leaves. Okay, this is the reason they are called evergreen. Actually, what is there, beta? Actually, in this forest, trees do not shed their leaves at the same time. Okay, means at a particular time, they shed their leaves in different times. That's why most of the trees in this forest remain green. Okay, that's why these forests are also known as evergreen forest. Okay, friends, now examples of the trees which are found in tropical evergreen forest. Hardwood trees like rosewood, ebony, mahogany, and these are common here. Understood about the first type of forest, tropical evergreen forest. Next one is there, tropical deciduous forest. Okay, yes, tropical deciduous are the monsoon forest found in the large part of India, Northern Australia also, and in Central America. Okay, these forests are also known as monsoon forest. Like tropical evergreen forest are known as rainfall forest, and deciduous forest are also known as monsoon forest. Actually, the growth of these plants depends on the rainfall which occur or come in a particular season. Okay, means these trees shed their leaves in a particular season, in dry season. Okay, this region experience seasonal changes. Trees shed their leaves in the dry season to conserve water. Okay, beta. So these are the differences also. Like in the evergreen forest, the trees do not shed their leaves in a particular season, but in deciduous forest, that they shed their leaves in a particular season, that is dry season. Okay. And the hardwood trees found in these forests are sal, tea, neem and shisham, which are used to make furniture, transport and constructional materials. So understood about these two types of forest. First is evergreen and second is tropical deciduous forest. And the wildlife which are found in this forest are tiger, lions, elephant, langur, monkeys. Means these are common animals which are found in tropical deciduous forest. Next is here temperate evergreen forest. Okay, these forests are found in the area temperate zone. Means the areas lies between Tropic of Cancer and Arctic Circle. Okay, and in southern hemisphere, that is Antarctic Circle or Tropic of Capricorn. Okay, so what are these temperate evergreen forests? The temperate evergreen forests are located in the latitudinal coastal region. Means these forests are mainly found in on the coastal areas. They are commonly found along the eastern margins of the continent. For example, in Southeast USA, South China and Southeast Brazil. Okay, friends, they comprise both hard and softwood trees like oak, pine, eucalyptus and etc. Got it about it? Now we will study about temperate deciduous forest. Okay, so temperate deciduous forest. Temperate deciduous forest are found towards higher latitudes means on the higher places. Okay, means you can say mainly are found on hilly areas. Okay, and temperate deciduous forest are found towards higher latitudes. Okay, they shed their leaves in the dry season, and the common trees are oak, ash, beech, etc. Okay, and the animals which are found in this forest are deer, foxes, wolves. Okay, now we will study about Mediterranean vegetation which are found along the Mediterranean Sea. It is mostly found in the areas around the Mediterranean Sea in Europe, Africa and Asia. And in this you can see area mainly citric fruits are found, means which are sour in taste, khatte, like oranges, figs, olives and grapes. Okay, in this area mainly fruits are cultivated. Next one is coniferous forest, cone shaped. Okay, that in this forest the trees which are found, they are of cone shape. In the higher latitudes of northern hemisphere, the spectacular coniferous forest are found. These are also called taiga, and these forests are also seen in the higher altitudes, and the main trees which are found in this forest, chee, pine, the cedar. Okay, they are the main varieties which are found in coniferous forest. And the animals which are found in this forest are silver fox, mink, polar bear. Okay, next about the homework. Yes friends, in today's lecture we have discussed about different types of forest. Okay, and in our next lecture we will study about next vegetation. These are grasslands. Okay. So, on the basis of the topics which I have explained you, now I will assign you some question answer which you have to do in your homework. Okay. So, in which the first question is there, which are the two factors on which the growth of vegetation mostly depend? This I told you beta during the explanation. Which are the three broad category of natural vegetation? Name the two hardwood trees commonly found in tropical evergreen forest. Question 4. In which part of the world is tropical deciduous forest found? And question number 5. In which climatic condition are citrus fruit cultivated? So friends, these are total means 5 questions which you have to do in your homework notebook, fair notebook. Okay, and now you have to make new notebook for essay 2. After writing the answers of this question, you have to submit it to me on my mail ID. Okay, that is morneetu8080@yahoo.com. Okay, friends. So, in this way, our today's lecture is completed. Tomorrow, we will meet again. Thank you so much.